Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Siege of Dragonspear Blind. I'm gonna finish exploring the warrens. See what else is here and maybe let these guys go. And then see if we can take the lift.
Yes.
I'm not sure if the lift is the only way up. We are still going up. This luxurious bed stands out in sharp contrast to its barren surroundings. Certainly does. Rhonda is over here? That'd be Rhonda?
It's good to see in the dark.
Indeed. Alright, so I'm not sure about that. It's a chest. I might get angry about that. Let's see what's in these barrels and such. Two antidotes and a potion of clarity. Nice. Five more potions of extra healing. Never have too many of those. Or, well, you can if it weighs you down. If you have like 3,000 of them or something. Oh, he just stacked this stuff with his. He has five of them. Someone needs more. I think Jahira. She has four. No, he has three. That's fine. Two. I'm gonna poison that often. I'll spread these out a little bit more. Take three of them. Here we go. And then, what's in here? A potion of stone form. Okay.
Stay back, or you'll regret it.
We work for the glory of Kalar Argent.
Good day, and hello to you.
This is a critical area. Be sure to keep intruders out.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
You've read that one before. There's three of them there, and then Rhonda. Let's talk to Rhonda last. Crusader officer.
You need something?
Mercenaries.
You be quiet.
We get to fight a lot in a crusade. I like fighting.
I read that before too. This is just a bed. I don't think there's anything else in there. Alright, let's talk to Rhonda here. If we can get out of each other's way. Oh, brother. Talking to Rhonda. I'm determined.
Oh! Who are you?
I'm not sure if we should be saying I'm the hero of Baldur's Gate to these people. Don't be afraid, I'm Sapphire. Are you with the Crusade? Not by choice. They took my family, my father and brothers. I don't know what happened to them. They found out I knew how to use a needle and thread and stuck me in this place mending their clothes. Is it safe to be telling her that? Get out of here. Run. as fast and far away from here as possible. I don't know if I should be saying all that to her. You're not with the Crusade, then? No, I can see you aren't. Your eyes are different from theirs. Do you all have the same eyes? I wish I had something I could give you. All I have is these gloves, but they look too small for your hands. Well, take them anyway, for luck, if nothing else. Farewell on your mission. Goodbye. Gauntlets. Oh, that's part of Glint Gardner's son. I told Rhonda that she could escape. I encountered Rhonda, a young gnome torn from her family and forced to serve the Crusade as a seamstress in the warrens beneath Dragonspear Castle. I advise her to flee through the underground river caverns. She'll not have a better chance to escape than she does now. Yes, watch out for the patrol. You could just act like you're heading towards the encampment by the exit there. And I got some special kind of gauntlets. So I thought she was in charge and that was her bed. Nimble finger gloves. Fashioned from the finest doe skin available, this pair of gloves was obviously designed for gnomish hands, though dwarves and other shorter races might also be able to use them. The goblins, maybe? For the right wearer, the gloves offer protection and comfort in equal proportion. Fitting like a second skin, the user becomes more sensitive to what their hands are doing. This added focus increases the wearer's nimbleness and dexterity. Dexterity plus 2 for gnomes and plus 1 for halflings, dwarves, and goblins. Pickpockets and set traps plus 25% each. Oh, are you wearing something on your hands? No, you aren't. I mean, I don't use you as a thief, but added dexterity has to help. Are you, This is as a result of what you're wearing. Yeah, I know the charisma is. Because of this stinky thing you're wearing. Crunter's armor, I think? Well, this is wisdom minus 1. It's this. It retains the sweat and odors of its wearer, which is... I forget exactly what it was, but it was a ghost of something. There's a lot of ghosts of things in this game. So that's what's behind the charisma minus 1. Okay, just making sure there's no ability drain or anything going on. So, in any case, I was distracted. I was looking at dexterity. 17. This might help armor class. I think it's the even ones that goes up though, right? Well, dexterity. Yeah, let's see. No. It's the odds. Armor class now is -4. Awesome.
Aye.
A little harder to hit is always a good thing. Alright, so I wonder whose bed this is. I don't think these guys are gonna like if I open a chest right next to them.
Yes.
So let's not try it. Bring the whole place down on us. Are we checking here? Just look. I'm pretty sure we did, actually. Yeah. Yeah, I'm not sure why. If you take things out of chests, they get mad. I picked a box somewhere over here. Might have been that one. And they were fine with that. And I picked a chest that was far away from people. They were fine with that. But those guys are just all standing right there. Alright, so let's check out up the other way. Oh, yeah, that's the second floor, I just realized, yeah. The gates of the hells themselves cannot deny we of true faith. Let's say. Well, there's no goods up here that we can see. What about that? Oh, just for show? Wait a second. The quality of your equipment far outshines the weaponry hanging from this rack. That's a good thing. Sure, I like the crusade. They pay up front. You're still not sure what kind of creature that is. Whatever it is, it's big.
You need something?
Something you need?
We work for the glory of Kalar Argent.
You are more than welcome in my sight.
We're authorized, baby. All manner of bladed weapon hangs from this rack. Though carefully polished and maintained, the craftsmanship on display is unremarkable. Oh, how sad for them.
You want bull?
Well, we'll talk to Crusader Priest Poli. Looks like that's it for this area. Hail.
I welcome you with outstretched hand.
Eh? What is this? Mercenaries neath the castle? Mercenaries? Nay, I serve the Shining Lady. See here, I bear her seal. You are a true believer in the Shining Lady's cause, then? Forgive me, friend. I judged you too harshly, forgetting that the Lady welcomes all people of good faith, regardless of their past deeds or, their appearance. Temple services. I embrace the Lady's philosophy as she herself embraced me. Only the Shining Lady herself might put it better. What can I do for you, friend? Tell me, how did you come to serve Kalar? My mother died when I was a child, leaving me and my sister and my father Polv's care. He was a good man, my father. When the devil spilled out of Dragonspear and ravaged the land nearly 10 years ago, he was among the first to stand against them. He was also among the first to fall. Leah and I were sent to live with my aunt and uncle. They were poorer than father, but no less noble in spirit. They cared for us as they did their own children. They were slain in the Second Dragonspear War. So were Leah and three of my cousins. I found some comfort in my faith, but when Kalar found me, I admit, I had begun to question Helm and all the gods. How could they allow this to happen? Kalar had an answer. The loss of our loved ones is a test the gods have set before us. A test we too often fail. We bow our heads, shed some tears, and shrug our shoulders, accepting what should be unacceptable. The dragon spirit dead were not lost, they were taken, and what was taken once can be taken back. Yeah, I'm not saying that. An awe-inspiring task, one I'd be better prepared to undertake were my body's strength equal to my spirit's. I need temple services. Can you help me, Pulvi? For a follower of the Shining Lady? Gladly. What do you need? Just don't need any of this. Oh. Identify something. This protection scroll. Cursed scroll of clumsiness. This scroll is cursed. It would be unwise to read it, as the effects could prove fatal. Bless us in our efforts. What we do for you. Well, it's a good thing we didn't just blindly take that. Anything more to say?
I trust you are here in good faith.
Okay. Well, we're done looking around.
What?
I said we're done looking around.
Thy called, I shall.
Dump this thing.
Huh? Let's talk more fight!
So. We can try to free these guys. Where are you going?
Yes, done and done.
Trouble?
Don't be a wandering mage around these parts, it's not a good idea.
Let's talk more fight!
Especially what we're about to do. We're away from the others, so they might not see us.
You want me? Whatever you like.
Alright. See if she can pick this lock. The lock breaks apart with a loud snap.
Slug free!
Now that you're free, how can you help me?
Nurse, all alone outside. Slug need find her, but first help you. In north end of river caverns is fresh water, good to drink. On wall next to pool is hiding hole. Ogre treasure there. It will help you kill shiners.
North end of river caverns. Next to pool is hiding hole. Now I'm guessing that's the cavern we just came from. That connects here. Ogre treasure there. You have my thanks, Ogre. Now, Slug, go use secret passage. Get past Shiner guards. Kill them if they get in way. Find Murs, and then we kill Shiners. Everyone we can. They take Slug away from Murs. Slug take heads away from bodies. I like the way you think. The Dungeon Slug. I can find the ogre cache near a pool of water in the northern caverns. After I freed Slug, he told me where to find a cache of ogre treasure in a cavern wall hiding hole near a pool of water in the northern part of the underground river tunnels. Alright. I'll try to find... I'm guessing they mean where we came from. And these guys don't notice them. How could you not notice them?
Aye, let's talk more fight!
What happened? Ogre death, worker death, crusader archer death.
Let's talk more fight!
Did they fight out here? Alright, well, I'm looking for a pool of water. I don't want to wait by this guy. Is that one of the ogres? Pool of water. There's no pool of water over here. It'd be the river itself. That wouldn't make sense. Here? This is the pool of water. A bundle of objects wrapped in burlap lies inside this cleverly concealed alcove. Oh, sweet. A bundle of objects.
Thy demand, I shall.
Now that I've retrieved the precious cache, I should check on Slug back at the ogre camp above ground. Oh. So we're leaving? Magical flail. Potion of fire giant strength, heroism, and defense. Alright, we'll go check on him then. That's for Minsk. I'll take that. And that. And this to identify. Three of these now, that's good. The Hydra, plus two. The three heads of this flail look like dragon heads, giving the weapon its fearsome name. As the wielder swings the weapon, its heads seem to blur and divide until a mass of Hydra heads whips from the end of the chain. When the wielder ceases attacking, the weapon reverts to its original appearance. Haha, that's pretty cool. 33% chance per hit of dealing plus 1d4, plus 2d4, or plus 3d4 points of piercing damage. That go plus 2, 1d6, plus 3 damage. Not usable by druid, mage, shaman. Now I'm guessing this is an addition too, so 1d6 plus 3 and then 33% chance of that more extra. It's too bad. It might be a good thing for Viconia. She's not with us. I wouldn't have Minsk use it. Druid, shaman can't use it, mage, and thief, so not really useful for anybody, unfortunately.
Yes?
Yes. Alright, so let's...
Sword first!
I guess we'll go check on them.
You want... Let's talk more fight!
Oops.
What?
Wrong key. Here comes the fog belching out. I didn't want to really want to walk all the way out here, but I guess we are. We can ensure that they'll...
This is the most fun I've had in weeks.
We can ensure that they'll help us then, I suppose. No surprise. How much time we spent. There's a lot in here just by itself. I thought it was going to be, you know, maybe three or four episodes. Oh, what happened here?
Keep watch for ancient tomes or any scrolls that might contain lost arcana.
Is this where the ogre died? Crusader Archer. There's also a worker died. Oh. Is that one of the ogres that was with Slug? Trying to home in on what he has here. Oh, we already took it? Yeah, I want that. It's just, it's that, obviously. I'm surprised we can't click on it. And that's the arrows. What about the worker? Come on, guys, move. I don't know. Oh, there's a worker. I guess that worker. Maybe one of them got killed on the way out.
Sword first.
You can go sword first. Just stick your sword out. Just ram into anyone who moves. All right, so this ogre camp is over here, but I don't... We can't walk through all this. We have to go around. For no more Myconids, I don't feel like fighting them right now. Oops! Oh, what happened? He got slowed? Hit by slow. Wait.
Trouble?
Oh, he doesn't have his ring on. Wait a second. Give me that. Oh. Where'd that one ring go? Someone else wearing it? Plus one. She's wearing it. Because I was tired of Minsk not being hasted. Well, now he's slowed. Plus one stacked over there.
Yes.
Hmm. We'll fix that. Except for her, of course. All right, just in case we get in a battle as well. Oh, who's this? Kaelin? You're not an ogre, are you? That looks like a drow, maybe.
Sword first!
Kaelin. Who are these people? Umar and Kaelin. Well, there's Slug and Murs. Hail, Slug.
Slug chief again. Soon we go back to caves, do what we do best, smash heads, take gold.
That's great, Slug. Maybe just try and limit the smashing to Crusader heads, yes? You save me and I see Murs again. Murs say me give you prize as thanks. Belong to my family many years. Still don't know what it does. I thought he was gonna say I'm belonging to his family for many years. Something magic. Maybe you figure out. That's quite the pedigree. I'll treasure it. Murs says, you have friend now. Elf, Vaprak watch over you like ogre. It good thing. Oh, sorry, that's some kind of magical ring. The reunited Murs and Slug are grateful for my assistance. Good. You go now. There's nothing else I can do for you. Chief says no talk to you. Now, who are these? Oh, are these the two that we rescued? Kind of? And they were very ungrateful?
You are welcome here.
After reaching the surface, we sought some place to take shelter while we determine our next move. That's when we saw smoke from the ogre's fire. We asked to join them. Murs agreed. Okay, so we rescued these two. I thought they were adventurers. It's pretty dark down there in the underground river cavern. And then we came across some drow who were talking about them. And they couldn't believe they'd go to the surface, something like that. So I was like, oh, them. Yeah, we saved them from Ankhegs, I think, and they were very ungrateful. I'm glad to find you well, but will life among ogres suit you? Kaelet says, certainly. We've seen many new things already, and the ogres say we can remain with them so long as we pull our weight. Omar says, we really can't thank you enough. Oh, now they're grateful. Kaelet says, I'm sure you have more important things to do than speak with us, so we will leave you to them. Farewell, Sapphire.
Good day.
Yeah, I do have more important things to do, actually. Alright, so off screen, if nothing interesting happens along the way, I'm gonna head back through the underground river cave, and then into the Warrens. I'll most probably meet you guys back in the Warrens, and let me pause so we have some haste left over to run over there. And we're going to talk to those two, I think they're ogres there, who were speaking. I didn't speak with them. They were talking to each other. And see if they'll let us up that lift. And that brings us into, I think, the basement of the castle? Someone said? Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.